It is a pleasure to have our Irish minister here today. Just in time for St. Paddy's Day in Savannah, right, Senator? So, Secretary, read the caption.
Senate Resolution 753 by Senator Kennedy of the 18th and others, a resolution recognizing and commending Minister Peter Burke and for other purposes. Whereas first elected to the Dáil Éireann in 2016, Peter Burke represents the constituency of Longford Westmeath and serves Ireland as Minister of State for European Affairs and Defence. And whereas he will participate in the 200th Savannah St. Patrick's Day Parade, which represents a monumental historic milestone. And whereas he continues to serve the people of Ireland with honor and distinction, and his vision and unyielding commitment to excellence have set the standard for public service. Now therefore be it resolved by the Senate that the members of this body recognize and commend Minister Peter Burke upon his visit to the state of Georgia for his dedicated public service and extend the most sincere best wishes for continued health and happiness. That completes the order, Mr. President.
Is there objection to the adoption of the resolution? Chair hears none, and the resolution is adopted. Recognize the Senator from the 18th to introduce our special guest.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, colleagues. You know, we have the honor of receiving a lot of distinguished guests and visitors here at the Capitol, and none are more fondly received than our friends from Ireland, and it is my distinct honor to get to introduce the minister here to you in just a moment. Much of what I was going to tell you about his public service and his education really were in the resolution, so I'm not going to take our time to double down on that. But, you know, the strong ancestral and historic ties are beyond worthy of recognition of the Irish companies that employ approximately 7,000 people in Georgia, and they are the eighth largest source of foreign direct investment in the great state of Georgia. As was stated a moment ago, Minister Burke, it will be in Dr. Watson's, the Senator from Savannah, the Senator from the first great parade that he is a great participant in this coming weekend. So the Minister has timed it just perfectly. We've got some other guests on the floor with us as well at the rostrum here, the Consul General. But I'll let the Minister Burke introduce the folks that are with him. And y'all please give a great Georgia Senate welcome to our friends from Ireland.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor, President pro tempore, Senators. It's a privilege to be here with our team, our Consulate General Cuiva here behind me, Emer, Deputy Head, and our other colleagues here from Ireland. It's a privilege to get this opportunity. I thank President pro tempore, Senator John F. Kennedy, for the opportunity to facilitate me speaking to you here this morning, which we really value as a country. It's a relationship, the US-Ireland relationship, that we really put resources behind, that we treasure, and it's demonstrated by this week about 20 cities hit between 11 ministers right across the US. And also we have our Consulate General here in Atlanta since 2010, 9 missions here in the US, and the best evidence of a good bilateral relationship is that it works both ways. And when you see, as Senator John F. Kennedy just alluded to here, the FDI investment in Georgia, but 7,000 jobs really coming from Irish-backed companies, companies like CRH, like Curry, working on the ground here in Georgia. Obviously for St. Patrick's weekend, it's an incredible accolade for us to get the opportunity to speak to you here this morning to demonstrate the huge relationship borne out by about 9.5% of the US population, 32 million people claiming Irish heritage, 1 million people here in Georgia, that we really value that relationship and we really nurture it into the future. I want to thank you for that, for being good friends and for being there for us at very difficult times in the past, like the Good Friday Agreement, which was really assisted by the US. I just want to make 2 very brief points for our mission here in the US this week, which are very important to Ireland on the foreign policy perspective. Firstly, in relation to Ukraine, we believe it is critical that we stand by Ukraine for as long as it takes. As a member of the European Union, this is the first war in a generation on mainland Europe, a country's territorial integrity being challenged by Russian aggression, its right to self-determination, a direct challenge on the international rules-based order. And we really need to stand up to that. We've demonstrated by a 50 billion euro package from Europe to assist Ukraine with its public services. So I really, really encourage everyone to keep up the resilience to stand with the people of Ukraine for as long as it takes. And secondly, briefly, just to mention the Middle East. We really abhor the acts of October 7th on the State of Israel. We've demanded unequivocally the release of all hostages by Hamas, which is very important to the Irish government. But also we were one of the first parliamentary democracies to call for a ceasefire. And we really believe we need to avoid proportionality, collective punishment on a very vulnerable people, and get humanitarian corridors opened up as quickly as possible. I want to acknowledge and thank the US administration for working with its interlocutors in the region, of which it has a very strong voice, to encourage and secure that such important humanitarian corridors and a ceasefire, to ensure that we can get back to the two-state solution right to the very forefront of our policy. And finally, dear friends, very important date, August 24th, when Georgia Tech are coming to be victorious in the Viva Stadium in Ireland. So go Yellow Jackets. Thank you.